Now, it really has been a rags-to-riches tale for our next guest. In just 3 years, this Irish lad and his group, The Script, have gone from aspiring musicians to scoring 2 number one albums and playing stadium shows with superstars such as U2 and Paul McCartney. What's more, in such a short space of time, they have already built an impressive catalogue of memorable hits. Please welcome lead singer of The Script, Danny O'Donoghue.
Hey guys, how are you?
Hello, hello. Welcome back.
Thank you very much.
You've been a busy boy since the last time you were on the show.
Yeah, we've been very busy. You always give me a great introduction to Rags to Riches. I'm still wearing the rags, though. You know?
Well, what have you been up to since the last time we saw you?
We've just finished our Science and Faith tour around the UK. Mm-hmm. We brought it over to Australia. Singapore, Manila, all basically kind of like a world tour. It sounds so pretentious to say that, you know, world tour. Now we're just back to promote the new single. And then we've got the next leg of the tour, which kicks off in America. You know,
we've got a little clip of the new single. Let's take a look.
Yeah, excellent.
Finished being edited yet? Is
we
that
just
right?
Shot it in Miami.
Okay.
In the last 3 days. So that was actually live footage taken from, I believe, the O2 concerts. 18,000 people.
Wow.
All there. Yeah, it was an amazing event for us. Yeah.
So how do you get an intimate atmosphere in such a big stadium?
It's very, very hard. I asked Paul McCartney actually the same thing.
Yeah. Oh, come on.
What did he say?
Listen to you.
Yeah, name dropping.
Bit of a name drop, but we'll overlook that.
Yeah, exactly.
But what did he say?
He just said, tell a story before the song. You know, people. They love to hear how the song meant to you.
Well. Yeah,
yeah, and connecting. You really, really draw them in. So you can actually make 18,000 people feel like they're on the stage with you. Mm-hmm. And he told us that, and when we went out to watch him play, and he did the same thing. Before one of the songs, he said, you know, I've always wondered what I would say to John if I met him again. And he started this song, you could hear a pin drop in the place. Because everyone's like, yeah, well, what would he say?
And explained it.
Yeah, you know, because he really opens himself up, and we definitely take a lot from his book.
Also, for you, when I was reading about you and your band, it wasn't like an overnight success
not
for you, was it? I mean, it's
no,
been...
it's the longest night of my life, to be honest.
Yeah. It's been a long road to get where you are today. What kept you going? Because nowadays it seems bands are made and the next day they've got a hit record.
I think just a belief in the music. You know, we've never been a band that's been, try to put our faces on our albums, or, you know, we haven't been about the look, and none of our friends or family are famous or anything like that. So we've done it the hard way, you know, that's just touring. So I think just for us was that one. I guess every band has a belief in themselves, but for us it was our music. You know, we really believe that our music has definitely the power to heal people. I mean, it was healing us going through our first album, was healing us going through a breakup, you know,
and you're not exactly ugly, let's be honest.
Thanks very much, yeah. That's your opinion, yeah.
Now, being away on tour a lot, does that mean that you try and sort of curry favour by buying presents when you come back?
Yeah, I know. I was listening backstage, and it is something that I definitely would say I would be very guilty of, trying to overcompensate for the time that I am away. But I believe that if it is the 2 hours that you get to spend, don't spend it on your phones, and don't spend it. You know, it's a very rude thing to be like always
be
checking
there.
The tweets, or be there, be on the one-to-one. You know, what I try and do is always just bring back a little momentum of where I was. You know, we were just in Mexico, so I brought back a little necklace with a little shark on it.
Buying love.
Kind of, yeah.
But your dad was a professional musician,
wasn't he? Yeah.
So he must have been away from home
a lot.
So did he come back with presents? How did it feel for you when he was away?
He always came back with stories, you know, and being Irish, that was kind of, I guess that was our money and that was our currency was coming back with. Wait and I tell you what happened. You know, and we all kind of said, you know yourself.
Yeah, yeah.
And we all sit around, and I think that's definitely something we kind of put into our songs is the art of the story, you know.
Was it a big, did you have a big family?
A massive 8.
Oh, yeah, so you like could all amuse each other then. You couldn't be given a toy that you wouldn't all fight over, probably.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
No, which is nice though, isn't it? I mean.
Yeah, we grew up, pretty much around the piano, around music, musical instruments as well. As I said, we were like the Brady Bunch. There's like two, you know, three boys, three girls, and me mum and dad. So I guess no matter how much money that you think you have, you don't have enough to spread around six kids, you know. So.
And Danny, as well, you touched on the fact that, you know, your dad would tell you great stories. Your songs are always very story led. There's always something behind. You know, it's not just, you know, met a girl, tra la la. What's the latest single about? Because it's quite it has the potential to be quite deep, really.
Yeah, Science and Faith. It was actually about a conversation or an argument that Mark, our guitarist, was having with his wife Rena. And they were sitting out the back having a couple of glasses of Shiraz, and he was standing there trying to explain away the sun, moon and stars, and breaking everything down to a science as men do, and I guess taking away the magic of the world. And he just seen Rena's face kind of dropping, like, you've just basically explained away love and what the feeling is. Mm-hmm. But she grabbed his hand, put it on his face and said, but this is what's real. You know, you can't explain faith or hope down a telescope. You're not going to find what we have in a science book. Yeah. And he came in the next day and he's like, you're never going to guess what I said last night. And I was like, go on. A good songwriting terms. I was like, you know, another hit song. But so we sat down and we wrote it, and we just thought it was a great yin and yang, give and take, push and pull of female and male. And I guess the trials and tribulations that we all go through every day.
No, it's good. It made sense. Now, the single, what, Science and Faith, is released on May the 30th.
May the 30th, yeah.
And good luck with all the tours.
We could have had out on the 33 and a third. There's not the date.
It's Danny O'Donoghue, everyone.